Thank you. That concludes the debate on college regionalisation. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is a debate on motion 9508 in the name of Humza Yousaf on appointment of a junior Scottish minister. I invite members who wish to speak in the debate to press their request to speak buttons. And I call on Humza Yousaf to speak to and move the motion up to 4 minutes, First Minister.
Presiding Officer, let me begin by moving the motion in my name that Fiona Hislop be appointed as a Scottish junior minister. Before I do so, let me first pay tribute to the outgoing Minister, Kevin Stewart. Kevin has been a key member of this government for over 7 years, serving in a number of different portfolios. I want to pay tribute to Kevin's bravery in being so upfront about his mental health. As a former mental health minister himself, Kevin knows full well how often we try and encourage each other to reach out to those around us when we're not okay. Telling people to do that and actually doing it are two different things. And let's be frank, as politicians, we aren't always good at practicing the advice that we give to others. Kevin will be missed from government. However, I have no doubt that we will see him back in ministerial office again soon, and I know that he will be given a very warm welcome by colleagues in the back benches. For now, I offer Kevin my sincere thanks for his services to government, and I'm sure the whole chamber will send our best wishes to Kevin. Turning now to today's appointment, Fiona Hislop is someone who needs little introduction whatsoever. As one of the longest serving ministers in the history of the Scottish Parliament, the wealth of experience she brings is almost without parallel. In education, Fiona abolished tuition fees, for which a whole generation of students are undoubtedly enormously thankful. In external affairs, she represented the Scottish Government overseas. She built strong and lasting relationships which serve us well to this day. And in economy, she worked tirelessly to support jobs and businesses during the pandemic. And of course, she is revered, I think that's too strong a word, within the culture sector for the support that she has given over the years. If I may say so, having served as Fiona's junior minister at one point in time, and having observed her over a number of years around the cabinet table, there are few ministers who will so doggedly, so tenaciously, fight for the interests of their portfolio. And I expect her to continue to do so. The transport brief is one of the most demanding in government. Having done the job myself, I know that it's wonderfully rewarding supporting the thousands of people working every day to keep Scotland moving. But let's be honest too, being Transport Minister in any government, you can get little credit when things go well, and you may find that the moment anything goes wrong, the whole country may well know who you are. But Fiona has the experience, she has the expertise, and most importantly, she has the ability to be an excellent Transport Minister. Presiding Officer, with Fiona's appointment comes the opportunity to make some minor changes in my government. I'm strengthening Mary McCallan's remit, freeing her to take a direct day-to-day role in transport and effectively bringing transport explicitly into Cabinet. I'm also using the opportunity to bring some extra support to the rural portfolio by expanding Gillian Martin's role and ensuring Richard Lockhead's title reflects his responsibilities supporting businesses right across Scotland. This will ensure that the significant policy plans of this government can be pursued with vigour. And with that, Presiding Officer, I move the motion in my name and I ask Parliament to approve Fiona Hislop's appointment.
Thank you. And I call on Graeme Simpson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Well, we're finally about to fill the job in government that no one apparently wanted. Humza Yousaf has managed to conjure up a fairy-like delay in replacing Kevin Stewart, who was, of course, the latest in a long line of SNP figures to decide for whatever reason that it was not for them. And I do, of course, wish Mr. Stewart all the best, and I've told him that. Now, transport is seen as the poison chalice of government, but only because everything goes wrong under the SNP. So let's hope that someone of Fiona Hislop's clout can get it right. I was going to say that I thought this should be a cabinet position, but I am pleased to see that Mary McCallan is getting transport in her brief. I'm delighted that Fiona Hislop has got the job. It needs someone of her experience with a proud record of delivery. For instance, the last time she was in government, she announced another delay to ferries 801 and 802, telling Parliament in August 2020 that the Glen Sannox would be delivered between April 2022 to June 2022, with 802 planned for December 2022 to February 2023. She was quite adamant, Presiding Officer. Now, we know the SNP are in hock to the Greens, but this new ministerial recycling scheme is evidence that they're in it all the way. It's a kind of governmental DRS, except we don't get the 20 pence back when we've finished with the minister. Anyway, I honestly know this, that I and Fiona Hislop can work well together. We can. We have become firm friends on the Economy Committee. And she has, of course, invited me along to see a cycle park in her own constituency, and I look forward to cycling round the course with her. It's important that we work together. Boats, trains, planes, automobiles.
Mr. Simpson, please continue. And can I ask that we resist any temptation to call out while Mr. Simpson is speaking?
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Boats, trains, planes, automobiles and the A9, they all matter. Without a properly functioning transport system, the country does not work. So I wish Fiona Hislop all the very best.
Thank you. And I call on Martin Whitfield.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer. And at the outset, can I extend to Kevin Stewart, at a personal level, my wish for him to regain his health, but also extend my admiration for the honesty that he's presented. And although it was but a short period of time that he was in office, I think he showed a heart to it, if challenged, about solving some of the problems. Which brings us to the nomination today of Fiona Hislop. There are few people who can come with as much knowledge, wisdom, and maybe even the T-shirt for government experience, having obviously formerly been a cabinet secretary, with responsibility for education between 2000 and 2009, when certain challenges in the education field led the then former First Minister to reappoint her as a junior minister for culture and external affairs. And we've heard of the influence that she gave during that period, all the way through, indeed, to 2021, when she decided, after 14 years, that she wanted to step down from government. How short that time that she had before being called back. But I would like also to take the opportunity with the current First Minister, as he repots his green portfolio and rearranges the deck chair, that was perhaps a missed opportunity to claim his deposit back from Lorna Slater's portfolio and perhaps try to put the fire out in the DRS scheme by redeploying someone new to that. I do welcome the appointment of the new minister. It is in, you know, an incredibly challenging brief, and it is good that that's now represented at cabinet level. So I do wish Fiona Hislop all the very best. I hope that the rising tide brings good fortune, but as tides turn, it may take others to put right the mess that has been led to. I'm grateful.
Thank you, and I call Gillian Mackay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. On behalf of the Scottish Greens, I want to welcome Fiona Hislop to her post. She's personally been supportive of myself as a new MSP and has been a constant contributor this session from the backbench and in committee, and as we've heard from others, comes with a level of clout that I think we need for this portfolio. We wish her every success in what we all know is a demanding ministerial brief at any given time. But as Fiona Hislop was Cabinet Secretary for the Economy during the pandemic, she's no stranger to challenging circumstances. We look forward to working with her on the scrapping of peak rail fares this October, engaging on the outcomes of the Fair Fares Review, and building on the success of under-22's free bus travel, as well as the decarbonisation of transport across Scotland. I want to thank Kevin Stewart and his various roles for his collaborative approach to the Bute House Agreement over the last couple of years. I want to echo the comments of the First Minister on Kevin Stewart's bravery. I very much enjoyed working with him when he was Minister for Mental Wellbeing and Social Care, and on behalf of the party, I want to wish him well and look forward to him being back in Parliament soon.
Thank you. The question is that motion 9508, in the name of Humza Yousaf, on appointment of junior Scottish minister, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. There's one question to be put as a result of today's business, and the question is that motion 9414, in the name of Sue Webber, on behalf of the Education, Children and Young People Committee on College Regionalisation, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. That concludes decision time, and we will now move on to members' business in the name of Katie Clark.